The very first reason that American women are hard to date is because they have the independent woman mindset. Now let's break this down. First of all, the humankind dichotomy is an interdependent world. We live in nature, we live in industry, we live in cities, we live in rural areas, which again are interdependent world. These functions of our worlds that we live in are dependent upon other things to happen. When you ask a woman to describe what does it mean to be an independent woman, she says she buys stuff and she has a job. And I'm sorry to break it down to you, but having a job does not make you independent. You're not really looking at the whole perspective of what's really going on. Your boss hired you, so you depended upon that person to hire you, and you definitely depend upon that person or that corporation to keep you employed with at-will employment. At-will employment means they can fire you whenever they want because they don't like the way you look, dress, talk, or what have you. So you mean to tell me that you're independent because you have at-will employment? That's not independent. See, because if you don't go to work, they take away your money and now you no longer have your money, so you're dependent upon them. And even if you're an entrepreneur like I am, I'm an entrepreneur. Now, I don't say that I'm independent. Why? Because I'm dependent upon my fans. I'm dependent upon people who buy my book. I'm dependent upon people who come to my shows. If they decide to stop doing that, now all of a sudden, I have to look for different sources of income. And it's a high possibility that that can happen. Just like it's a high possibility that you can get fired from your job. So if you think making money makes you independent, then you have a complete falsehood of what it means to be independent. There's no human being that is independent. We are all dependent upon other people. For us to get our behavior, all human behavior is learned. You depended upon other people to learn behavior. If you're such an independent woman, then that means you should not be asking your friends for advice. That means you should not be asking your mother or your father for help in the house at all. You should be completely self-sufficient. But that's not realistic, because 80% of the people in America right now are living check to check. So are you part of that 20%? Being an independent woman actually is a big turnoff, and let me explain. If you go up to a man who has a lot of value, who has a lot of things to offer you, and you're talking that attitude, that independent woman attitude, that's going to be a turnoff. Because any man that's looking to create a family, any man that's looking to be a contributing part of a family, looking to be the quote-unquote real man like women claim they're looking for, he's looking for a woman who could be a teammate. He's looking for a woman who knows how to submit. He's looking for a woman who knows how to play her role, because he knows how to play his role in the dichotomy of a relationship, of a family. And women with this, oh, I'm an independent woman, they don't understand the way relationships actually work. Because an efficient relationship between a man and a woman is what we call an interdependent relationship, where both people bring value, content, consistent success to the relationship. So when you say, oh, I'm an independent woman, you are basically saying, oh, I don't need a man. And if you don't need a man, the man doesn't need you either. But we will go find a woman who does need me. We will go find a woman who wants to love me. We will go find a woman who wants to be a woman and who wants to be a functioning part of a family unit. So you can keep being an independent woman, but then at night when you have nobody to call on, all the men are turned off of you there because you think all your degrees are more important. You think your bank account is more important. You think your status is more important. I mean, how do you feel? Like, that's the real question. How does it feel to be an independent woman, but you're lonely as hell? Nobody will date you. You're undateable. How does that make you feel? You crave the attention of a man. You crave the love of a man, of a good man. But you're not able to attract a man, or you're able to push him all the way because you're so independent. When are you going to stop doing that? Now, I'm never going to crush anybody's dreams and say, don't chase your dreams. I'm never going to say, don't chase your money. I'm never going to say, don't create, because that's what I do. That's personally what I do. But I'm also a man. And I don't expect my woman to do that. I expect her to chase her dreams. I expect her to chase her passions, not money. I don't expect her to chase money.